Hi, my name is Chris Herrick, and I am an Igor Pro software engineer at Wavemetrics. Igor Pro is the root software that Sutter Patch is based on. Today, I'm going to talk to you about how to import data into Igor Pro. So I think that's a really important piece of the puzzle when working with Igor. And there's lots of different ways to import data. And I want to just walk you through some of the most common ones. This is Igor Pro that I have up right now. Here is the command window where you can type in commands. I'll just make a quick wave. We'll just name it W and we'll put some real basic data in it. And if we display that as a graph, then you can see in the window browser, my available graphs and tables will be shown here. And here is the data browser that shows all of the waves that I have created. An experiment is the word for a collection of Igor objects. And these objects are stored in an experiment file that has a PXP file ending. It's very common for your data to already exist in another Igor experiment. And a lot of people don't know it, but it really is dirt simple to copy data waves from one experiment to another. So that's where I'm going to start. I'm just going to close this real quick. So in the data browser, there's these five buttons to the left-hand side, and the middle one is Browse Experiment. So if I click on that, I'm going to pick one of the experiment files that ships with Igor, the multi-peak fit demo. We just open that up and you can see in the data browser the waves that are in the multi-peak fit demo experiment are shown here, and we can browse them and get a preview here in this bottom window of what the data looks like. I want these my x data and my y data waves. I'm going to use the shift key to highlight both of them, to select them both. And all I have to do is drag and drop them into my root data folder. And here they are in my experiment. You can also use the command key to highlight more elements, to select other. You can even select entire folders, even everything in the whole. You can just pull over everything in the whole experiment if you wish. And you can have multiple of these open. You'd select between them here. And when you're done browsing and have all of the data that you want from that experiment into your new experiment, you just hit done browsing. So now let's look at these waves in a graph. So we just do display my Y data versus my X data. These wave names have spaces in them, so I've used single quotes to be able to use them on the command line. And here we are. Looks pretty good. And that was very, very simple. Another really easy way to pull in data is to import from an Excel spreadsheet. So I have an Excel sheet here, and these are actually the same waves. They're just copies of the same waves that I pulled in from the example experiment in the last step. I have a time series and a data series listed here. Excel doesn't like you to import or do anything with the file in the file system until you have closed the Excel spreadsheet. So I'm just going to close that here and then go back to Igor, and I'm going to import that spreadsheet. So I just go to data. Load waves, load Excel file. I'm just going to hit file, and here's my simple data.excel spreadsheet. We're going to open that, and all of these defaults are fine. There's wave names in the worksheet on row one, double precision waves. If the wave name already existed, I'm going to overwrite. I'm going to get rid of the blanks at end of any columns. And here is the command that's going to be generated and run when I hit do it. So here we go. Here's my table. We can scroll through and see that the data came in nicely. And here are the new waves x time and y data. Let's graph that again. So this is going to be y data versus x time. I didn't need quotes that time because these names didn't have any spaces or funny characters in them. And you can see that the data is exactly the same and the graphs look the same. So that worked great. One thing I also wanted to point out is all of the actions that I'm doing through the GUI, they have equivalent commands that you can either use on the command line directly or in an Igor procedure script. And most of the time when you run something through the GUI, it's going to print out, it's going to display in your history here in the command window, the command that it ran. And that's really, really helpful because especially for complicated commands such as load wave, it's a great way to get your command working. And then you have the command in your history, and then you can use that later in an experiment that you want to automate in some way. So we've pulled in the Excel file, we've shown how to do that. I'll just go over that again. It's data, load waves. And here are all the different kinds of waves we can load. The next one we're going to do is I'm going to show how to do a custom data format. So in this data file, I have one column that's dates and one column that's data. On the date column, you can see that this is going to be month, day, and year without any separators. Often we'll find that dates in particular can be in very interesting formats. Sometimes you're not completely in control of how the file format comes to you, how your data comes to you, and you have to just work with it as it is. Igor tries really hard to be able to help you parse whatever data has come to you as is without you making a lot of edits to your files beforehand. And one way that we do that is through custom formatting. So if you need special custom formatting for your data, you'll want to save the data file in a CSV. In this particular instance, I had this in a spreadsheet and I just saved it as a CSV file instead of an Excel file. And Excel made this for me automatically using a comma as the separator, as the delimiter of the data. So to import custom dates, what we're going to do is, again, we're going to go to data, load waves. We're going to go to the load waves, this first one. And this is the full dialogue for all types of waves. This data here does have names. So I'm going to say read wave names. I'm also going to have it make a table because when I load waves, I like to see the table right when it's imported just to show what it's imported, what the data looks like to make sure everything imported as I expected. And I'm going to keep double precision checked and I'm going to go to this tweaks button. So here we want to focus on the date format option. We're going to choose other and that brings up another dialog. Under common format, there's a lot of different options here. I want to highlight a couple things. If you, for example, have any of these options that say either abbreviated or full, that's going to include the names of the months or maybe day of the week, you know, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, but it might also be in a different language. So you can select the language here. That's not relevant to this data particularly, but I just wanted to highlight that availability for you. We have month, day, year with no separators. So that's one of the common formats that's automatically there for us. And we can tell here in the sample section that this is what it's going to look like. Today's date is always one of the options to see. So it's 12/10/2024, and that's great. If we did, for example, if this was different in some way where we wanted to use a custom format, we can do that as well. We can have the year be 4-digit or 2-digit. We can have a numeric month with a leading zero. We can have abbreviated alphabetic month. So that would be DEC, for example. So we have lots of options. No leading zero is also an option, and we can put them in different orders, and we can put in our own interesting date formats, you know, whatever it may be, we have those options. But we're going to use month, day, year for this. There, that's good. And then we'll select the file. This is our custom date CSV file. We'll open that, and here's the command that's going to be generated, and we'll do it. Now, after you've done any custom tweaking, you'll see this preview of the data that's going to be pulled in. It named X date. That's good. The column format is number here, and we want to show it that this one's a date. So we're going to hit that. And this is the name of the Y data 2 column. That's just a number, double precision. That looks great to me. And we'll hit load. Now we can see the table of data that pulled in, and we can see that it is definitely a date. So that worked correctly. Now let's graph that real quick. So we pulled in X time and Y data too. So we want to do the Y first and then the X date. Is that correct? Let's see. Yes, here we go. So here's our graph for our date. You can see that at the bottom it says date. And if I double click on this axis, I have some options for how to display the date and time format. In the ticks and grids tab, I can do date format long. Let's try that. And here we can see that it changed to Sunday, December 15th, 2024, Monday, December 9th, 2024. So you can really edit how you want the format to look without changing the data at all. And that's some really nice formatting that's available to you in Igor. So the last thing I want to show is importing data that has a header and a footer. Sometimes your data is going to come in with a header and sometimes even a footer. And that's also going to be easy with Igor. All we have to do is we figure out what's the first row of our data and what's the last row of our data. I'm going to quickly make a notebook, a formatted notebook, just to make some notes here. The start of our data is line 20, and the end of our data is 12,583. So end is 12,538, excuse me. That's really all we need to remember here. And we need to do a little math. So I'm going to just type out a command here. 20. Igor's counting for line numbers is zero based, so 20 minus 1 and then plus 12,538. Since I'm in a notebook, I can just highlight that and I'll copy paste it. So we need 12,557 lines. I'm going to go to load waves. This one doesn't have wave names in it, so I'm going to uncheck that and go to tweaks. I'm going to go back to just the default date format, though it's not important in this time. Line containing column labels is none for this example. Our first line containing data is going to be line 19. And the number of lines containing data is 12,557. We're going to click OK. We're going to pick our file, which is this one here. And we're going to see how it did. So we have wave 0, that looks good. Wave 1, 2, 3, 4. It thinks there is a 5 because there were some extra spaces, but there isn't. So we're going to skip that column and load. Here we have our data. And it goes all the way to the bottom without any of the header or footer information. And so that's my demo.
Thanks a lot, Chris. That was very interesting. Even for somebody who's reasonably familiar with Igor, I've learned something new, and I'm pretty sure a lot of the audience got a couple tips and tricks along the way.